10-9-8 is a wonderful, inspirational film, and I want to thank Mary Mazzio for all of her leadership and hard work to make this happen. The dropout crisis in our country is real. 30% of our high school students never graduate. Today, unlike 30 years ago, there are no good jobs out there, and basically every child who drops out today, I believe, is condemned to poverty and to social failure. Teaching entrepreneurial skills, Nifty's leadership is a big part of the answer. I was lucky enough to have them as a great partner in Chicago. The stories of these students, what they overcome, Rodney Walker, who I had the good fortune to get to know and work with in Chicago, is simply extraordinary. Giving our students a sense of what they can accomplish, their tremendous potential, tapping into that entrepreneurial zeal will help students who would otherwise fall by the wayside not just be successful, but go on to be tremendous leaders. So I want to thank Nifty for their remarkable work, not just in Chicago, but around the country. Collectively, we have to end this dropout crisis. This story helps to both shed light and heat on the issue that we have to deal with concretely in a real way, and Nifty's going to help us get where we need to go as a country. Congratulations. Enjoy the film. It is remarkable.
I went all throughout my life feeling like I've been cheated.
Ronnie can't afford to fail.
I remember days, stomach be growling, wearing the same clothes maybe 3-4 times a week.
If you lose something, you always have to go and try again.
Money is the motivation.
You know, you have a life ahead of you. It's a waste of time to just stay here and do nothing with it.
See, my brother, he didn't make it out.
Of my friends that were in that neighborhood, some are dead, some are locked up.
I knew it was a 50-50 chance that I would make it.
Because here's what we're up against. 1.2 million of us will drop out of high school this year. That's one kid every 9 seconds.
It was a time where I didn't think I was going to stay in school.
50% of African American, Hispanic, and Native American students will fail to graduate with a high school class. That's right, people, 50%.
You have to have a certain faith and passion to not go down those roads.
75% of state prison inmates are high school dropouts. No surprise there.
When you're a have not, you try to figure out different ways to have.
It might come out good or you might be dead.
And the death rate for those of us who quit school, you don't even want to know. But there's one statistic that is more hopeful. 80% of dropouts would have stayed in school if there had been courses that were relevant to their lives, that could help them with the obstacles they face every day. This is the story of a competition and how a few of us learn skills that might help us beat the odds and find a way out. Skills like how to start a business, how to figure out profit and loss, how to talk to an investor, how to become an entrepreneur.
You just hear so many kids who don't think school is important. They don't think math is important. They don't know why they have to go to English class. And they start entrepreneurship education programs and they take off because they realize, I've got to do math because I've got to do my economics of one unit. I've got to read and go to English class because I've got to put my business plan together. So entrepreneurship definitely gives them a pathway to success.
The Network for Teaching Entrepreneurship teaches these courses in low-income schools and then runs a competition.
We get to see the kid who just came in from the hood and didn't have a clue, couldn't spell entrepreneur.
I didn't even know what entrepreneurship meant.
And they are the confident to able to walk into a room of adults, talk confidently about their business, their return on sales, they know their numbers. It's an amazing process.
One day your struggle is going to prepare you for greatness.
I don't want to end up falling through the cracks
with the regret of
not fulfilling my purpose.
Being a disappointment.
I don't want to end up in jail
where I can't make my own decisions, turn my own key.
I don't want to end up dead.
This year, 24,000 of us, from Harlem to Compton, and all points in between, we all learned how to write a business plan. For businesses ranging from organic candles, to custom guitars, to innovative football ice shield technology. Most of us did it for a class, for a grade. But some of us actually had real businesses going. So we all took our business plans and entered Nifty's National Business Plan Competition. 24,000 entrants. Only 100 will advance to the regional semifinals.
Welcome all of you to our Nifty Regional Business Plan Competition.
My name is Rodney Walker.
My name is Anae Montague.
My name is Natalie Johnson.
My name is Hong Chang.
Ugo Gamba.
Evelyn Espinosa.
Matt Friedman.
Doris Buchanan.
Brian Riley.
You got me, baby.